rain in the area, but we've been given the go-ahead to get this one started. It's a custom league battle under the lights between the Seattle Mariners and the Chicago White Sox. Stay tuned. White Sox baseball is next. Now to the plate, J.P. Crawford, and we are set for baseball here this evening.
Leading off tonight for Seattle, the shortstop.
First pitch of the A.B. on its way. Fastball just misses. That's ball one.
First pitch, 7 o'clock.
Just off the outside that time, laid off for a ball. The 2-0. Gets him to chase a ball out of the zone for the first strike.
Oh, I love that pitch right there. Up and in, jam, sandwich.
Reined in. And there's one away. Up next, Jake Fraley.
The left fielder, Fraley.
First pitch on its way. Fouled off.
Hey, when you're featuring a mid-90s fastball like this pitcher, attack with that pitch. Get ahead. Get the offense on their toes. That opens up the off-speed pitches later in the game.
1-1 the count. Taken in by Abreu, and he'll take it onto the bag himself. Two gone now here in the first. Digging in now for the Mariners, Ty France. First chance for him here in the top of the first with nobody on. Pitch on the way. Checked his swing there. Did he go around? No, says the first base umpire. Ball one. Two out, nobody on. Changed things up on him, and he got him to swing through it. 1-2 now.
Only one strike away from throwing a very strong first inning to begin the ball game. He looks sharp.
And the throw is in time. It's a strikeout, and the play at first goes 2-3 for good measure as the inning is over. And that'll bring up the shortstop, Tim Anderson. He'll lead things off here in the bottom half of the first.
For the White Sox, the shortstop, Tim Anderson.
Comes set. Here's the nothing and nothing pitch. Swing and a miss on the sinker. 0-1. Might have thought about it here, but he lays off the breaking ball inside. It's even at one. Even at a ball and a strike. Here's the pitch. Swing and a miss as he pulled the string on him. 1-2. Swing and a liner. And he lays out, but he can't make the play, and it's through into right.
Adam second. The right fielder, Adam.
To the plate Engel. Now, Adam Engel. Now a bunt attempt here, but this is foul for the first strike. Anderson on at first, nobody out. A swinging strike, and now it's 0-2. And a bunt attempt here with two strikes that'll get foul, so he'll become out number one. The batter will be Luis Robert. First chance for him here with a runner at first and one gone.
Luis Robert.
He's set and the pitch. As the first pitch to him is in there for a called strike one.
You can really tell they're trying to keep the ball in on this big slugger right here.
Is that an effort to keep him from getting extended, do you think?
Yeah, I think that's the idea, Matt. But he might spin to win if he starts looking for it in there.
And that'll get down for a base hit. And they'll have runners at the corners following the one-out single.
Batting four.
Here's the catcher, Yasmani Grandal.
Yasmani.
This will go after the first pitch and bounce it into foul territory. And they're runners at the corners now. The 0-1. Swing and a miss here, and he's behind in the count now, 0-2.
Big pitch coming up right here. He'd love for a ground ball or a strikeout.
Squared that one up just a little late. Had him fooled as he swings through the curveball. Two down. So runners at the corners with two gone. And one of the more prolific RBI men in the league the last few years, Jose Abreu, will bat next. High in the air down the right field line. And no one will track it down. Runners on first and third, two away. High in the air out to center field. Lewis waits on it. No problem with this one, and the inning is over. Mitch Haniger the next to bat. He'll lead it off here to begin the second. First offering on its way. And he throws the fastball by him here, 0-1.
Hey, guys, that fastball just registered 97 miles an hour. On a night like tonight where it's super cold out, if you don't get to head to that baseball right there and you get jammed, it's almost like getting stung by a pack of wasps.
There to make the catch is Jimenez, and there's one away. That and now here is Kyle Lewis.
Kyle Lewis.
He's ready. Here's the first pitch. Starts him out with a slider for a strike.
Hey, you could tell right there the hitter was almost fooled by that pitch, expecting the nasty slider to break down and away, and it hung in the middle of the plate. Too late for him to pull a trigger.
Now the 1-1 pitch. And he fouls this one off. No score here as we play inning number two. To short. Anderson brings it in. Throw gets him. Two down. So the bases are empty with two gone now. And into bat next, the third baseman, Kyle Seager. And that swung on and missed for strike one.
Great execution of that changeup right there. Great arm action. Batter was totally out front on that one.
Seager behind with an 0-2 count. And that's a swinging strike three in the dirt. Grandal gathers. The throw to first is in time, and the inning is over. Bottom of the inning now, and that'll give way to the veteran second baseman, Cesar Hernandez.
The second baseman, Cesar Hernandez.
Ready to deliver. Here comes the first pitch.
Nope. That's his time.
Now here's the pitch. In the air out to center field. And a high bounce will take it over the outfield wall, and he kicks off the inning with a ground rule double. Standing in now, Emo Jimenez. And on the first pitch, he grounds foul. Runner in scoring position here already following the ground rule double. Fouled away. Here it comes, 0-2. Lifts it into the air to shallow center. Chasing after it is Lewis. He makes the catch. A great effort to get there and record the first out of the inning. So now here is Gavin Sheets looking to put them ahead early with this at-bat. First pitch of the AB on its way. Hernandez leads off second with one gone in the inning. Got him reaching there. Strike two.
Well, he's following the code not to miss down and into a lefty. Everything on the outer half of the plate.
Stung into the gap in right center for what should be extra bases. As he arrives at second without a play, as they jump ahead with a run scoring on the play.
Batting nine. The third baseman.
So here's Yoan Moncada. As he'll swing and send a chopper out to second. Fielded cleanly. And there's out number two. And the next to bat will be Tim Anderson. Runner in scoring position with two gone.
Tim Anderson.
From the stretch, here's the pitch. As he grounds one briskly to short. Crawford gloves it. Throw in the dirt, but a good scoop at first saves an error as this side is retired. So stepping in is Jared Kelnick, 7-8-9, bottom of the order, set to go here in the third. First pitch on its way. Swung on but fouled off to the left.
I love everything this pitcher's got working right now. He's got presence, he's got great body language on the mound, he's got fastball command and a nice early feel for his off-speed stuff.
Now a check swing, but he holds up in time, ball one.
Hey, that's not an easy pitch to hold your swing up. I know it looked like it was way out the plate. Good job not swinging at it.
Good deception on the slider there as he's way out in front. And the throw will indeed take care of him for the first out. Now at the plate, Abraham Toro.
Second baseman, Abraham Toro.
Infield shifted well to the right. Here's the first pitch. And, ooh, I'm not sure you can get fooled worse than that. It's 0-1.
Man, that's another ugly swing right there. This team is just struggling so mightily to get on base. They've looked off balance all game.
One out, nobody on. Center fielder looking up, still going back. And it's gone!
Only the first hit of the night, but it was a big one. He absolutely punished that mistake, and you have to wonder if that will open the floodgates a little.
Stepping in now, Luis Torrens.
The catcher.
As he'll swing and miss at a first pitch slider at strike one. And boy, was he ever fooled on that pitch. It's 0-2 now.
Ooh-wee, that was an ugly swing. I'm sure he's not going to watch that one on replay after the game.
Got him swinging in the dirt. He makes the throw to first. Two down. And that'll bring in J.P. Crawford. Second appearance here. He grounded out to start the ball game. Now the first pitch. Bases are empty here with two men out. And it's fouled away. And a check swing here as he couldn't help himself, and it's ruled strike two. Lifted down the line and left. But this is just going to wind up being a foul ball. Here's another 1-2.
Man, this guy's a grinder. Fouls off good pitches and doesn't seem to swing at the ones just off the corner. This guy's a pitcher's nightmare.
Swing and a miss got him reaching. Grandal has it, and the throw to first ends the inning. Bottom of the third now, and up next, one of the best defensive center fielders in the league, Adam Engel.
The right fielder.
First pitch of the AB on its way. Couldn't hold up on the curveball there as he went around for strike one. He'll try to bunt his way on as he gets this one down. And the throw will be too late, so it's a bunt single to get him started here.
Now batting, center fielder, Luis Robert.
The next batter will be Luis Robert. And a pitch out, nothing doing though, and that's ball one. The 1-0 home.
2-0.
That can be one of the downfalls of pitching out. It puts you behind in the count, and if you throw another ball, you're kind of in a difficult spot.
2-1 now. Engel aboard here at first with nobody out. Too high that time, and it's 3-1.
They know the threat this guy poses at the plate. I know it's a 3-1 in this situation right here, but I cannot believe for the life of me this pitcher is going to come anywhere near the middle of the zone.
Prior to the 3-2, we'll look to first, and he's back easily. Out of the stretch, the 3-2 pitch home. Gets him looking at the knees for the strikeout. Ready now is Yasmani Grandal, struck out in his last trip to the plate. First pitch on its way. Now here's a fly ball, well hit. Going back is the left fielder, and it's gone. That one cut through the sky like a hot knife through butter.
I think if this pitch would have been a little higher and in on his hands, it would have been effective. But he left this one belt high. Big mistake. He's a guy that will feast on belt high pitches on the inner half, which is pretty obvious now.
Now back, the first baseman, Jose Abreu.
So here's the slugging first baseman, Jose Abreu now. He swings and hits it foul off to the right and out of play. Flew out in his only at-bat so far. Now he'll step off. Fouled off. Another one sent foul. A pause and the 0-2.
He's got a good feel for his off-speed pitches second time through the order, and we just saw three in a row.
Lays off that time, and it's 1-2.
After multiple pitches were fouled off, it gets a little disappointing as a pitcher. So you think, say, I'm going to throw one way off the plate and see if he'll chase it. Didn't happen.
Again, a 1-2. To two balls and two strikes now.
This is exactly the reason why this guy has been so successful and has played this game so long, scrambling pitch after pitch, making this guy work out on the mound.
And he can only battle for so long as he's finally set down here after an eight-pitch at-bat.
Hernandez.
Digging in next, Cesar Hernandez. He scored a run after stroking a double in his first at-bat.
Well, he got a good pitch to hit last time up. Looked for it up in the zone and didn't miss it. Those are the pitches you only get maybe once an AB, maybe once a game, maybe once a week. So he certainly capitalized on it last time.
First pitch coming. Here it is. Yes, he pops the first pitch foul behind the plate. Two out, nobody on. And he fouls this one off. Protecting with two strikes, went out of the zone that time, but he stays alive. The next 0-2. And a half-hearted swing there as they tie him up inside for the third strike, and the inning is over. All set for the start of the fourth. And at the plate will be the speedy outfielder, Jake Fraley.
Offense needs to get going right here. You want to try and tighten up this game a little bit before it starts to get into that territory where you're going to start seeing the back end of each bullpen.
Owen. Won the count. And a check swing here as he couldn't help himself, and it's ruled strike two.
There's another pitch for a strike, and this guy's really attacking hitters well tonight, being aggressive early on. And if he continues to throw strikes like he is, he's going to have a pretty good night.
And a changeup swung on and missed for the first out. So here now is Ty France. Comes into this at bat 0 for 1 in the ballgame. First delivery to him. And that's waved at and missed for strike one.
Man, this guy's been incredibly efficient so far in this one, mostly because he's getting ahead. 70% of the batters he's faced, he's thrown a first pitch strike to.
He'll take this in without much trouble, and two are gone here to start the fourth. Now at the plate, here is Mitch Haniger. Flied out. His first at bat, so make him 0 for 1 so far.
Almost, Matty. Almost went deep his last AB. Certainly just missed it. With this guy's big power, he's feeling pretty good at the dish. Look for him to try and get on something and drive it out of the yard this AB.
3-1 is our score here in inning number 4. And he struck him out, his 7th of the ball game, and that ends the inning. Ready to go in the bottom of the fourth. And up next, the exciting Eloy Jimenez.
The left fielder, Eloy.
Ready to deliver. Here comes the first pitch. In there, and it's 0-1.
0-1's the count.
Now here's the pitch. Sinker, and this one's over as well. Nothing in two now.
0-2 is the count.
After two great pitches, he has a lot of options right now. He could bounce something or go elevated fastball.
Sinker misses, and it's 1-2 now. And he won't go after the cut fastball. 2-2. Here it comes. And And he tries to get him to reach for it, but it stays outside. 3-2.
Well, you don't see it all that often, but this might be a good time for a 3-2 change. If he can locate it, it's nearly impossible to hit.
So he got him swinging. Eloy Jimenez is dealt with for the first out in the bottom of the inning. From the stretch. Into right field, that's a base hit. Next to bat will be the Cuban import, Yoan Moncada. Yes, he'll take a look at ball one. Can't sit back long enough, and the count evens up at 1-1. Cheats, base runner at first with one out. Good break to that thing, and it's 1-2. From the stretch. Good bite to that sinker as he gets him to swing through it for out number two.
The batter, number
so there
seven.
Are two gone now in the White Sox fourth. Here. And up next, it'll be Tim Anderson. Strike one to start the at-bat. A runner on first with two away. And that one yanked just foul. In front there as this one's pulled off to the left side. Now a breaking ball runs in on him as he's got to get his hands out of the way on that pitch. Breaking ball swung on in the dirt. Torrens finds it, and that ends the inning. All set for the start of the inning, and next it'll be the outfielder, Kyle Lewis.
The center fielder, number one.
Ready to deal. Here comes the first pitch. Oh, and a half swing there on a pitch out of the zone. Indeed, it's strike two.
Got him.
And that's eight strikeouts now for him in the ball game. Here's the third baseman now, Kyle Seager.
Kyle.
He's ready. Here's the first pitch. And no swing, apparently. Ball one. 3-1 our score as we play inning number five. And a changeup here, but that's taken low in the dirt for a ball. Fouled away. The 2-1 home is swung on and missed for strike number two.
When the pitcher on the mound's established in this kind of heater, you got to come off everything else and find a way to get that.
He pulls this one high and deep to right center field. See you later. Over the wall, a home run.
Yeah, and if you remember the previous pitch, he couldn't get around on a fastball and was mad at himself. Well, there's nothing to be mad about anymore, unless you're the guy standing on the mound wondering what just happened.
Digging in now is Jared Kelnick. As he'll get caught chasing a bad one there at strike one. Struck out in his first at-bat. And a good idea to hold off on that swing. It's ball one.
He's going to have to take a deep breath. A little bit ultra aggressive at the plate right now after fishing at the first pitch and looking like he was going to commit on that one.
Ball taken there. 2-1 now. Into the windup and the pitch. That gets down and he's got himself a base hit. Aaron Bummer enters to make an appearance on the mound as he inherits a runner at first with one out in the inning. At the plate, Abraham Toro. No balls and one strike. Ready with the 0-1. Almost got the corner, but it's inside for ball one.
That's a good pitch to lay off right there, that cutter inside. And that is a real tough pitch for hitters to lay off of. And a lot of times, if you do swing at that cutter in, you're going to end up with some firewood and a broken bat.
The next 1-2 pitch. Looked like the cut fastball there, and he got him to swing through it for the second out. At the plate now is Luis Torrens, looking to put the ball in play here. He went down on strikes in his first at-bat. And a cut fastball here that he started off a bit too far inside. It nearly got him. And it's fouled away. Runners off for second. And this one runs in on him as he can't get his arms extended. A great pitch there, and the inning is over. Set now for the bottom of the fifth. And that'll bring up the outfielder, Adam Engel.
The right fielder.
First offering. Tries to catch him napping, but he missed the bunt attempt. Strike one.
You could tell he had made up his mind in the batter's box that he was taking that one with him. Great execution of a changeup. Kind of spoiled his plan right there.
Up next for the White Sox.
So one down, no one aboard. And in the bat next is Luis Robert. Now here's the first offering. Swing and a chopper to the left side. Crawford fields it cleanly, and there are two away now. Two down, no one on base. And that'll bring up Yasmani Grandal. Now the first pitch. There's a changeup taken, but it finds the zone on the inside. Did a good job to shorten up and protect the plate, and he'll have another shot at it here. The 0-2 once more.
Yep, tried to backdoor him and lock him up with a curveball right there. Pretty good pitch, but he didn't quite get it to come back all the way to the corner. That's tough to do for most guys.
Lewis waits on it. And the inning is over. Top half of the sixth about to get started. And stepping up is the shortstop, J.P. Crawford. First pitch on the way. The 1-0 is swung on and missed, and that's strike one. Had him off stride that time, and it's 1-2.
Hey, newsflash, think he was guessing, boys? Because that was an ugly swing right there.
Popped him up. And he'll stay with it here as he puts the squeeze on it for out number one. Next to dig in, Jake Fraley. He went down on strikes last time up.
Yeah, but it was a good changeup, Matty. Good arm action on that pitch. Look for him to try and stay back a little bit more. Let the ball get a little deeper. Don't be shocked if this pitcher tries to rush a heater right here.
Now a late bunt attempt here, but he misses strike two. And he pops him up back behind second base. And quickly two are gone now here in the visitor's half of the sixth. Two gone now in the Mariners' sixth, and that'll bring in Ty France. And now the first pitch. And that's by him. It's 0-1.
That was a great hack right there. Timing was on point. Just sometimes you have bad bat barrel accuracy.
A ball and two strikes now. 3-2 is our score here in inning number six. A leaping try, but it's out of his reach and into the outfield. And now it'll kick around in the corner. Stepping in now is Mitch Haniger. Bouncer up the middle. And that'll get through into center field for a base hit. The tying run is in to score from second. Into the box now, Kyle Lewis.
Anderson scoops it up. Throw over to Abreu is in time, and with it, the side is retired.
Bottom of the sixth inning now, and digging in is the big-time power threat, Jose Abreu.
The first baseman.
As he'll go after the first pitch and bounce it into foul territory.
Way the 0-1 pitch. Oof, and it's safe to say he doesn't look all that comfortable up there. 0-2 now.
After that off-balance swing right there, you find yourself down 0-2 and wishing you were back on deck with the donut on your bat, visualizing hitting a home run.
Lewis waits on it. One out. Next up, Cesar Hernandez. One for two with a double on his line thus far.
Hernandez.
First offering. No balls and a strike to count. Hit in the air to straightaway center. Lewis is there, two gone. Now in the box, Eloy Jimenez. He struck out swinging in his last trip to the plate. First pitch on the way. One count, here's the pitch. Swinging a ball hit on the ground, and there's his first base hit in this one.
Now batter, the designated hitter.
And now Gavin Sheets. And this one's in the dirt. In front of the changeup, and he can't keep it fair. Two strikes on him now. Here comes the nothing and two pitch.
Nope.
Not a bad pitch there with two strikes, but it misses 1-2. Little slide step action there, Dan.
Yeah, he's clearly thinking about the steal right here.
Meanwhile now, this is a fair ball down the line in left, and that ought to be good for extra bases. Jimenez rounds third and is digging for the plate. In to score is the runner from first. Oh, and he takes his eye off it here, and it goes right past him.
Up next to Chicago, the third baseman, Yoan Moncada.
Now time is called, and this could very well be to buy a few more pitches for those relievers. To the plate now, Yoan Moncada. Four runs, nine hits, and no errors so far for the White Sox. Back up the middle. Throw in the dirt, but a good scoop at first saves an error as the side is retired. Garrett Crochet is on to pitch from the bullpen now to start inning number seven.
Number 45, Garrett.
Into the box, Kyle Seager. A hit and two tries for him so far. First pitch on its way.
The third baseman,
as he can't catch up on a fastball to letters, and it's strike one.
I can't imagine in a hitter's meeting today that's the pitch they want to attack. Plus velocity up and in. It's going to be too tough to get the barrel to that pitch today.
Oh, and they pulled a string on a good changeup there as he swings and misses, and he's set down on strikes for the second time tonight. Now here it comes.
Jared.
Jared Kelnick is in with one away now as he swings and misses here at strike one.
Swing and a miss on a nasty slider right there. Always felt toughest pitch in the game. If you're a guy who liked to work the big part of the field, you were on that fastball middle away. That slider looked like a heater for about 56 feet, 6 inches.
So he chased out of the strike zone on that one. Jared Kelnick is the second out in the seventh inning. Now the first pitch. Into the windup, here comes the 0-1.
Lucky he got a piece right there. He was definitely late on that pitch after seeing a previous off-speed pitch.
Great changeup there in the dirt for the third strike. Grandal gathers. The throw to first is in time, and the inning is over.
Number hitting stretch.
Now back to the top of the lineup. Stepping in, Tim Anderson, who went down on strikes in his last at-bat.
Not shortstop. Tim Anderson.
And he'll step off and try again. Now time is called as both guys in the bullpen are ready to go.
Ladies
Joe Smith gets the call from the pen to take the ball for the home seventh.
Seattle, number 43, Joe Smith.
He's set. Here it comes. And he lays off a pitch in there for the first strike.
You know, some guys just don't like pulling the trigger in an 0-0 count. They don't like the ambush tactic. They like to calibrate the speed, maybe pick up the break. They want to know everything your ball does before they pull the trigger.
Crawford is under it, and that's the first out of the inning. Next to stand in is Adam Engel, popped into foul ground his last time up.
Yeah, Maddie, and I think that pop out was just a result of poor pitch selection. Got to see the pitch over the heart of the plate. He chased well out of the zone, and as a result, didn't really put a good swing on that.
Set to deliver the 0-1. Oh, and this at-bat is quickly moving from bad to worse. It's 0-2 now.
Made him look silly with that one.
Good job to spoil that one away, and he stays alive.
You can definitely tell with that foul off right there that he's picking up spin on this pitcher's off-speed stuff. Maybe expect a fastball on this next one.
Another 0-2 coming. Ground ball, left side. And this is going to find its way into left for a one-out knock.
Now batting.
Here's a look over at first. Just keeping him close.
Robert.
Into the box, Luis Robert, as the first pitch to him is swung on and missed for strike one. He's working on a 1-for-3 thus far. Out in front here is this one scorched, foul to the left.
Good speed at first and good speed with a guy at the dish. Going to be tough to double up these guys. If you're an infielder, got to get rid of it quick.
And a check swing. Did he go around? No, says the first base umpire. It's ball one. Ready with the 1-2. A great pitch there as he couldn't get extended on that one, and he's down on strikes for the second out.
The catcher.
And now here's the cleanup hitter for the White Sox. Yasmani Grandal flew out last time up. This is line to left, and that's in there. Base hit.
Now back.
So here's Jose Abreu in the air down the line in left. And the two-out threat won't pay off. The inning is over. Ready to begin the eighth, and now it'll be the catcher, Luis Torrens.
Catcher. The Correa.
Third baseman hugging the line here. Now the first pitch, as he'll get out ahead of a changeup and swing through it for strike one.
Don't expect this pitcher to overthink this right here. You get an ugly swing like that, rinse and repeat.
Behind 0-2 now. Nothing in two count, and the pitch fouled off. Got him, and he goes down on strikes for the third time. And stepping in, J.P. Crawford. No hits in three tries so far. He struck out once. Now a big fastball, and he's well. Behind it with the swing.
Well, he kind of tipped his hand right there. His approach is obviously sitting on the off speed because he was so late on that first pitch heater.
0-2, the count to Crawford. And this is taken in easily, and just like that, two are gone to start the eighth inning. Now next, it'll be Jake Fraley. He could really use a knock here, 0 for 3 in the game so far. Swing and a miss that time. Strike one.
Hey, this is a huge at-bat right here. This pitcher wants to end this inning and have 3, 4, 5 due up to start the next inning.
A windup and the 0-2 pitch. A swing and a miss on a ball way outside the strike zone, and the inning is over. Bottom of inning number 8 set to go, and that'll bring in the second baseman, Cesar Hernandez.
The second baseman.
Ready to deliver. Here comes the first pitch.
Hernandez.
And a check swing here as he couldn't help himself, and it's ruled strike two. Inside, as he might be trying to set him up here, 1-2.
That's a great take right there. Great pitch recognition to let that one go. Opposite-handed, that's coming across the plate. You might think you got a shot to stay inside that one.
Fraley is there, and he makes the catch for the out.
Now
next, it'll be Eloy Jimenez, singled in his last at-bat. First pitch of the AB now. Hard liner to center field. Lewis is there now, and he has it, two gone. Striding in is Gavin Sheets. It was an RBI double for him in his last turn to the plate. Comes set. Here's the nothing and nothing pitch. And he fouls this one off. The 0-1 pitch is swung on and missed, and that's strike two.
You have to find a way to lay off that low sinker. There is just no way to do any damage. You're just looking at either a bruised shin or a ground out to the left side.
Bases are empty here with two men out. The next 0-2 pitch to him misses outside. And a slider swung on and missed, and the side is retired. Liam Hendricks
please.
Takes the ball now in inning number 9, looking to close the door.
Number 31, Liam.
Stepping in once again is Ty France. He hit a two-bagger and later scored in his previous plate appearance. Here's the first pitch. And we kick off the ninth inning with a swinging strike here, nothing and one. Oh, he had him fooled there. No balls and two strikes.
Hey, let's see if the fish are biting, if he extends it out there a little bit more. 0-1 looked like it was off the plate. Let's see if 0-2 is even further outside the zone.
So he racks up the swinging strikeout on the breaking ball. Ty France becomes the first out in the ninth inning. Mitch Haniger stands in as he swings and misses for strike one. Swing and a miss, and he's in trouble now, 0-2.
That was an excellent pitch right there. After going soft away, he pounds hard in, and that's a nice pitch.
one-run game here in the top of the ninth. And it's another K. So back-to-back strikeout victims to start this relief outing. Next to hit is Kyle Lewis. Two outs already on the K this inning, so he'll be looking to do better. Strike one to start the at-bat. Tying run at the plate, the 0-1. Checked his swing there. Did he go around? No, says the first base umpire. Ball one. Two out, nobody on. And this is swung on and missed, so now they find themselves down to their final strike tonight.
Boy, he looks strong out there on the mound this inning. He's got a chance to punch out the side in order and against the middle of the order, too.
Last chance for the Mariners. And he holds up on this one, but it's a called strike three. And with that, the ball game is over.
And a nice job here to come in and slam the door. That's his first save of the season, but it certainly won't be his last.
And it's a 4-3 finish in this evening's ball game. Chicago rode an important sixth inning to victory in this one. Aaron Bummer takes home the win.